Hello.
Hello. Dog.
Sorry.
Kim, this is my son Tyler.
Hi,
this
Tyler.
Is Kim.
Nice to meet you.
He's in training.
Awesome.
Yeah. Hey,
so
buddy.
Doug.
Yeah. How you doing, Doug? You're a big boy.
He's gonna be a year next month.
Okay.
So we're learning to not jump.
Sure.
I can put him outside though.
No, you're
that
fine.
That was my intention.
You're
originally.
Fine.
I like the beard.
Thank you.
That was not there last time I saw you.
Nope, it's been a few years.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's nice when it's cold out, but it's with the weather we're having now, it's like. This is a weird time.
It is. So I want to give you like a little background on the furnace.
Sure, what's going on with it?
Last Friday, it started blowing out cold air, and it started flashing amber. Ben changed the furnace, and he cleaned whatever that coily thing is, and it's been fine since.
Okay.
But I just thought, well, before it breaks,
okay,
maybe just have you look at it, make
yeah.
sure everything looks okay.
I'll go through it.
Okay. Sounds good. You remember your way down
there? Yep, sure do.
Down there to the right.
Yep, and the thermostat's right around the corner,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, I tried to hang up most of the cobwebs. So.
Okay.
Let me see this. Come here,
down. He's going down. Take the front bumper off. Okay.
Can I get a knee pad?
Yeah, if you want. So go ahead and shut this gas off. So we'll test the flame sensor. Sounds like he already took care of the problem, but we'll test it anyways. Nope, microamps. Yep, perfect. Go ahead and kill that switch on the side real quick, on the other side. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, never mind, go ahead. I thought I was gonna relight. Okay, flip her back on. It's a little low, so we can take it out and clean it. Should we shut that gas off? Might need, I guess you can get it right there. How's it look?
Don't look too bad.
It's a little, yeah. Let's clean her up with the brush. You don't see any grooves or anything on it, do you?
Not really. really.
Okay. Yeah, I cleaned it up really good with the brush, and then we'll test it again. Remember, don't give her the onions until you get it going in there straight. Oh, is it in there straight?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and put, let's test it again. Hurry before it starts. Where's your meter? Oh. Oh, a lot better. All right, let's go ahead and vacuum stuff off, and then we'll check blower amps and all that stuff. Wait, don't turn that off. You gotta remember, you gotta let that blower run for a little bit. Yep, so you don't get overheat that heat exchanger. If you want, yeah. Go ahead and shut it off now. It's getting ready to light up again. So it's 10 years old, so maybe we will do a combustion check on this as well. When I drilled that out. Yeah, go ahead and kick it on. Let me see it. Do 80%? Huh? Yeah. So I'm going to so you got to go to 80% combustion. We'll see where that falls in. Well, it's because you got different percentages of furnace. You got your natural draft, or you got your 80%, and you got your kind of condensing furnaces, which are 90%ers. So you got to set this up for that particular application. Our O2's drop, and that's what we want to drop that a little bit. CO's still good. Well, the hotter it burns, the less O2 or the less O2. So we wanted to get it into the green if we can.
don't see the heat exchanger being an issue. I mean, it could be. He cleaned the flame sensor. I don't know. Go out to my truck and grab my CO detectors. Two of them that are in the center console. Yep. Both of them. There's a Testo and a UEI.
So I have updates. I pulled the high limit switch out and I stuck my Milwaukee scope down there, and I found what seems to be hairline cracks or splits on top of the heat exchanger. I did pull the blower out, didn't see nothing under there. So I decided to pull the limit out, and that's what I found. So, and we're not going to replace the heat exchanger in this. We're going to replace the furnace to a high efficiency, an upgrade. Customer chose to do that. Couldn't get the heat exchanger due to supply chain.
I believe that is a crack right there. And right there. So definitely the combustion analyzer does not lie. Yeah, they're just hairline splits. But my son took out the carbon monoxide detectors and zeroed them out and came back in. And they were reading, started out at 1, they went up to about 4. So, yep, we got an issue. So we'll have to probably replace this heat exchanger.